In this video, I want to walk you through everything you need to know to very easily create a video strategy for social media for your business coming up. What's up, everybody? My name is Karim Mustafa. I'm co-founder and CEO of Tribe Tactics. And in this video, I want to walk you through everything you need to really just get the ball rolling when it comes to coming up with a video strategy for your business. And here's the thing, right? Like, there's so many different things that come to mind once you start thinking of video strategy. And it could be very easy to get lost in all the different things that like your competitors are doing, things that you're seeing online. Everything seems like the new, you know, latest shiny thing, and you can't really tell which one would work best for your business. Or maybe you've seen some things, but it just takes so much resource and time to pull off. So today I'm hoping that I can share with you something that you could really apply regardless of what budget you have, regardless of what resources you have internally, and something that you can essentially create, you know, a minimum viable version or product of it very, very quickly, even if you're a team of one or if you're a team of 10. So I'm going to walk you through three different things. We're going to walk through show concept, we're going to walk through topics, and we're going to walk through guests. And all of that is going to make sense in just a sec. I'm going to open up this document over here that I have prepared, and yeah, basically let's get started on this and let's do this live together. So when it comes to video strategy, you know, for social media, again, it's something that's so general and there's so many different things that come to mind, but I'm going to share with you something that is very tried and tested and is really easy to set up, especially because you only need to create it once and you can really just set it and forget it, or set it and apply it, you know, day in, day out, month in, month out. And that is basically coming up with a show concept. So it's exactly what it sounds. Imagine if, you know, like Netflix or, you know, HBO gave you a call and they said, hey, congrats, we want you to do a show about your industry, or rather for your industry. Let's say you're in construction or a specific branch of like fintech, or, you know, in medtech or what have you. Imagine coming up with a show idea for that specific industry. What are, you know, what are the different storylines that you would think of? What genre would your show be? And what would the audience, who would the target audience be for this show? So these are the exact same things that, you know, that we're discussing over here. So one of the things that come to mind is, you know, the genre first and foremost. There's so much educational, formal content out there, which is great, but, you know, ultimately people are people, and you know, they want to be entertained by the content that you're putting out. It doesn't hurt to actually add a bit of entertainment in the content that you are creating, and it does create for a really solid video strategy for social media, because it's something that's both engaging but also educational in the same way. An example of that would be to do something like a, you know, video podcast show. This is one of the easiest and most timeless things that you could create, where you're essentially in conversation with other people in your industry or perhaps in adjacent industries around, you know, the state of things right now and, you know, what the future looks like. You know, maybe you find a specific angle on it and you really build an entire show around that specific angle. So a video podcast is a great one. But another one that you can think of is doing something like a reaction video series. So think of this as almost like a news show where you're reviewing pieces of news. It doesn't have to be physical. It could also be online, or reacting essentially to, you know, new trends that are happening in your industry, and you're essentially giving your commentary on it as your company. And this could include just general commentary, which will add perspective to other people, or it could also be content and commentary that will, you know, aim to give practical advice to people, but again, doing it in an engaging way, doing it under the lens of really creating something like a show. So yeah, genre is a big one for sure. Beyond that, of course, is looking at the goal of your show. So broadly speaking, your goal, the goal for the show could be one of two things. It could be building brand awareness, okay? Or it could be building, you know, sales and business development as such. And naturally, we all want both, right? Like if you're doing a marketing strategy, or more specifically a video strategy, naturally you want to see results on both those fronts. But as you'll soon see, it does pay to really pick one or the other, depending on what stage of growth you're at in your business. For example, if you're just starting out, it makes sense and it really does pay to invest in brand awareness, even if that means just investing your ideas and your time. Of course, if you're further along the line and you are really looking to prioritize sales results, you may decide to go with a business development approach. So broadly speaking, from a show perspective, the difference between them is that, let's say you decide to do a show around brand awareness, this is going to directly impact the type of topics you discuss, as well as the types of guests that you bring on board. For example, if you're looking to do brand awareness, you may decide to look at and tackle essentially the hot topics of your industry right now, the ones that you know for a fact are being searched for a lot, the ones that are almost like FAQs in everybody's mind. And it could be something that is specific to your industry or specific to like a larger, phenomena that's happening, like if you take like COVID-19 or what have you, but essentially taking a hot topic and really finding ways to drive perspective from your company towards that to really engage and entertain other people, but also to educate them as well. So that's in terms of brand awareness. And as well for guests, you may decide that, you know what, I'm actually going to bring people who are more or less influential in that space. They might have a set number of followers on LinkedIn, on Twitter. They might have a certain clout score before actually bringing them onto the show, because you know then that these are people who will be able to bring a lot of great perspective to your joint audiences. But naturally, when the content gets published, they will have large networks that could potentially share that content onto you as well. So now moving over to building a video strategy for social media for sales. The difference here is slightly nuanced, in the sense that basically in this case, you're looking at how you can get maybe a list of like your top 10 to 20 prospects or target accounts, or just businesses that you hope to be in business with, and really reverse engineering that and finding all the different common points that they have that you can essentially use to build a show around. So think of it as something that maybe they all have experience in, or something that they've all successfully tackled, or something that they all have an opinion on. This could be a great way to really build a show around it and have that show themed as such. And if for anything else, it really helps you to build a great warm relationship with these people. Even if you haven't met them before, it's a great way to really give them value first by giving them a platform where they can voice their thoughts and their ideas and their experience, both for them as their personal brand, but also for the company as such. So that's as far as show concept is concerned. Genre and goal are two things that you could really use to help you come up with an idea for perhaps a video podcast or reaction video series, and to do so in a way that is quite robust and engaging for your audience. So speaking of which, the next point then would be guests. So the different guests that you will bring onto your show will essentially be dictated by what goals you have set first and foremost. Again, whether it's brand awareness or whether it is business development, as mentioned. So when it comes to guests, you want to get people that are, ideally, people that your brand can get behind, and vice versa, people who believe what you believe and really have that culture fit, so to speak. Because naturally, when this content goes live, these are people that are going to be associated with your brand and vice versa. So the degree to which you understand your audience, the easier this will be for you in terms of really figuring out who would be a good fit for your specific show and your specific brand overall. And then last but not least would be topics. So after you find the people, you want to make sure that you can match that to topics that would play to their strengths. You obviously don't want to put people on the spot. You want to do topics that are very interesting and engaging for your audience based on your research, but in the same time, something that plays to these guests' strengths as such. This way, even if they are, like a little bit camera shy, or even if they're not really used to being on shows all the time, you're still putting them in a place of real confidence, because they're speaking about something that they know pretty much inside out, especially if it really shines a positive light. Perhaps it's an anecdote of how they write like a before and after story of like how they managed to overcome certain things, so on and so forth. So when it comes to building a video strategy for your business from a social media perspective, coming up with a show idea really helps to make things a lot easier for you, because you come up with the show, and now you, rather than thinking in terms of brand new campaigns and brand new videos, you just think in terms of episodes. So every episode has a different guest and a different topic, different guest and different topic. In some cases, you may decide to tackle multiple topics on the same episode or multiple guests on the same episode. And you could start off by recording this using Zoom, right? But you can also record using your smartphones. You can actually do both together, where you can then swap out the smartphone camera video footage instead of the Zoom recording and instantly, you know, do a remote call, but a remote meeting, but also just get such higher video quality in that regard. So hopefully this was helpful. Let us know what you thought in the comments. And if you have any questions, we'll be sure to create content around that in the future. And I'll see you next time. Cheers.